Kenya lifts ban on Uganda's dairy products. UMA rallies members to embrace renewable energy. Kenya's electricity use drops on higher prices. South Sudan's oil sector pulls in more deals. And African airlines operating below capacity. Now, the business community across the region wants taxes and protectionist laws reviewed, as they say this would help their products become more competitive. The conversation is about if they're paying more money and they're not competing favorably. Now, they're paying taxes and they're not competing favorably. It's something they think needs to be revisited. It's a conversation that the government will tell you we need the taxes to meet all the different needs in the country. But also the business community will tell you the heavy taxes are affecting our performance. And if we are to pay these taxes, then there must be a guarantee that value for money will be seen. I tell you what, it's a conversation that will forever stand. If you look at the targets that the URA has, maybe it's just over time, and we'll just keep waiting to see what this means. My name is Simon. Thank you so much for joining us on The Business Show this week. From wherever you're watching, we're glad you could make time. Here's what you can expect on the show tonight.
The good thing with trading, because it's high turnover, you can grow your profits or reward quite quickly. So that's why it's attractive. The other thing I mentioned, things like land or houses as well. You can also buy land, yeah? And I think it's a trade we've all tried.
Welcome to the show. My name is Simon, and from wherever you're watching, we're glad you could make time this week. Now, shea butter has become one of the most marketable products amongst Uganda and South Sudan women. And of course, there's some men as well involved in the value chain. But this has created an impact. The women are earning millions, the locals are feeling much better, and the production is actually increasing. However, there are issues of standards, access to market, and generally how to benefit through the value chain. We have understood that most of these women are operating as individuals, and as a result, they're not able to break through the market because, like I keep saying, someone walks to them and asks, can you supply constantly for the next 1 year? And someone can only do 3 weeks. So as a result, they are losing out on the market. This week on Views from the Top, I speak to Claudia, who is the project manager that has been handling these women. And interestingly, they have formed cooperatives to support these women and the men. And they are saying it is working out. Let's listen in from Views from the Top.
Claudia Tusingwile, and I work with UWIL, Uganda Women Entrepreneurs Association Limited, on one of the projects that is aiming at transforming the lives of men and women involved in the share value chain in northern Uganda.
So I know for a fact that this project has been running for close to a year and 6 months now. Maybe first of all, why did we choose to deal in shea butter of all commodities?
Okay, you will chose to deal with the shea value chain because of the problems that we realize that are affecting the women and men's lives that are benefiting from the shea value chain, first of all. First of all, the sector itself is not organized, and people collect nuts as individuals and sell the nuts and shea butter as individuals. So in the process, they end up losing the benefits they would be enjoying in terms of getting a good price for their shea nuts. Secondly, the sector also does not have enough information on issues of post-harvest handling. Basically, as post-harvest handling, when we talk of that, we mean how to harvest the shea nuts, sorting, drying, storage, and packaging. So we realized there are bad practices in post-harvest handling, and we managed to secure this project, which is funded by East African Women in Business Platform, based in Tanzania, from our partners as well, Enhanced Integrated Framework, that's EIF is the donor, passing the money through the East African Business Platform in Tanzania. So it is a kind of multidisciplinary project. We are working with different partners. And this project is also operating in South Sudan. So we have South Sudan Women Entrepreneurs Association on board as well.
Okay.
So we work with them, and they are also developing the shea value chain within South Sudan.
Okay. Yeah. So coming to the next 6 months, which should be then having the project close, maybe the first question then would be, what impact from the things you've mentioned, you know, the market, I mean, the sector not being organized, the dealers being cheated because they sell as individuals. What impact has this project created in the value chain?
Okay, the project, first of all, it has trained over 2,200 individuals, both in Uganda and South Sudan, in cooperative formation. We have helped the communities that we have dealt with to form cooperatives, and in case of Uganda, we are in 24 districts across the shea belt, and so far we have 10 cooperatives formed in the different districts. We have also trained 4,160 individuals in issues of post-harvest handling, how to sort the nuts, removing the bad ones from the good ones, how to store the nuts so that they remain with good conditions, and how to build a shea business. The project is also in the process of constructing a shea processing facility in one of the districts that will be probably chosen. Maybe we are looking at either Kitugum or Agago district, which is in Acholi sub-region, and this facility will enable women who are mainly the majority who dominate the shea value chain, especially in collecting the nuts and processing, to get access to technology that will enable them to produce good shea butter that is at the international standards. That is, we call it cold-pressed shea butter.
Okay. So you talk about international standards, and I'm just thinking, just of what importance, or where do you think generally as a country we stand when you talk about shea butter, and do you think we have utilized the available avenues to boost on the production of shea butter and also value addition and then export?
Okay, as a nation, we are blessed to have shea nilotica, which is known for Uganda or East Africa. And the government is generating good revenue in form of foreign exchange through exports of shea butter. And a good number of women and men, they have ventured into shea processing. They have different processing facilities, and they are able to export as individuals. And that one attracts foreign exchange as well as getting income for the individuals involved. However, the sector, as I had earlier said, it is not yet well organized. And majority of the entrepreneurs who are involved in shea butter trade, they do not know where to sell. looking for markets. The market is there.
Yes.
And the value of the shea nilotica that we have, it is known internationally. It is a good kind of shea butter for cosmetics and pharmaceuticals. Mm. But Uganda has not yet positioned itself very well to reap from this sector.
Okay. And yes. You know, when you talk about the fact that we have not positioned ourselves well to reap from the sector, but also the fact that most of the people dealing in this particular product are women, maybe does that then talk to us about what it means to operate in a formal system, formal kind of trading, where, you know, like you say, don't have all the right structures? Is that something you want to speak to?
I would say that the value chain for any commodity, it has to look at issues of production, policy, and regulations, then quality and standards. Mm. So to tap into the international market, you have to have all those aspects intertwined together and worked on. Mm. So yes, we have, for instance, we have the national shea butter strategy, which guides on export aspects of how to prepare yourself to export shea butter. But we do not have a policy yet or a law that is working on protection. At the same time, we do not have the shea population, shea tree population. So at times when a trader or an entrepreneur in shea butter is trying to look for the markets, the intending company to import from Uganda's shea butter will ask you issues of sustainability. How many shea trees? If I give you a contract, how will you be able to give me the supply for how long? So you find in most cases they are asking for the shea statistics. How many shea trees do you get this shea butter? So in that case, we are missing as a country because we don't have statistics about the shea trees that we have in the country, so that we are able to value how much we can supply in terms of production.
Okay. As we come to the end of this discussion or this conversation, really, the question would be, so you have formed or you've helped these women and men form cooperatives. So what next?
What next? You know, Rome was not built in one day. Mm. So at least this project has done what we call preparatory and eye-opening on the shea benefits and value for the communities. At least now there has been increased awareness on the benefits of the shea value, why we need to protect this, how we need to handle the processes. So we hope in the next few years Uganda, we are positioning ourselves to be better suppliers of shea nilotica as one of the raw materials to add value.
So it's important that we look into standards, and cooperatives will forever stand because the moment you speak as one voice, there's so much that you can do together, from bargaining on the market to agreeing on the most important things that could help you as business people. So we can only hope that this works. And given the fact that now some of these women and men are now cutting the trees to burn charcoal, now that's another challenge, because just, you know, these trees take between 15 to 20 years before the next time they mature. So it means if they cut them down, I don't know what they're planning to do, but this will just mess the whole production chain, and what could be benefiting the society could be a short-lived opportunity. Cut, sell the charcoal, done. But if we keep it for the shea butter, maybe we'll make more money. All right, you're watching the show with me, Simon. Let's take a quick break. In the meantime, feel free to get us on our social media pages. That's on Facebook, Twitter, and on Instagram. I'll see you after this break.